Hello, graphing inequalities. There is a way that I can show all possible answers of what a variable could be when you're having an inequality written down. So I have two examples written on here from the previous video that we had. And I just wanted to go through how do I actually graph these two inequalities to show what all the possible answers are. In the last video, we discussed that inequalities have more than one number that it can be. An equation only has one number. So if I had r equals 30, r can only be 30 in that statement. But in this statement, r is less than 30. That means r could be any number of numbers that are less than 30. So remember, they could be 29, 28, 27, 26. So it can be all of our whole numbers. And it can be all of our rational numbers, such as fractions and decimals. So it could be half. It could be 1 8/10. It could be 29.9. It could be 29.99. It could be 29.9 with a million nines after it. So it could be a number of numbers that are less than 30. So when I graph this, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to place a dot on 30. This is going to be an open dot. It's going to be an open circle. If I wanted to say R is 30, R equals 30, I would place a solid dot right there because that's R is 30, okay? But R is any number less than 30. So what I'm going to do is since R could be really, 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 really close to 30, it just can't be 30. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put an open circle on 30. This just means that my number, my integer, my rational number, can be any number as close to humanly possible as 30. It just can't be exactly 30. Okay, so I put a dot on zero on 30, and it's an open dot. So we call it an open dot. It's not filled in. Then any number that is less than 30 is the direction I'm going to draw my arrow. So I know that 29 is less than 30. 28 is less than 30. So when I take my arrow, I'm going to go towards those numbers, okay? And that is how I show all my solutions that are less than 30, okay? All right, so we had the example that the cookies were more than four. There were more than four cookies, all right? So again, more than four cookies, that means we could have 4.5 cookies. We could have four cookies and then just a little nibble, so 4.1 or 4 1/10. So again, we're going to put an open dot on four, meaning it can be really close to four. It just can't be four. And I want any rational number that's bigger than four or greater than four. So I know that five is greater than four. So I'm going to go ahead and draw my arrow towards the larger numbers, okay? Now, a lot of sixth and sometimes seventh graders think, well, just because my inequality symbol is pointing to the left, I need to put my arrow to the left. But I can flip-flop these numbers and symbols, and that's not always the case. So you really need to think for a minute and think, what number can I replace R with or C with? And that's the direction I need to put my arrow. Because I can rewrite this inequality is 30 is greater than R. So 30 is greater than R. Well, what number can I still put for R? I can still put 29. And here my inequality is not pointing the same direction. So really think, what number makes this work, and that's the direction you need to go. Same with C is greater than 4. I can put 4 is less than C. I can rewrite it that way. My inequality is flipped, and now I'm not pointing the same direction as my inequality. So again, I need to think, what number can I replace C with? And I can replace C with 5. 5 is greater than 4. 4 is less than 5, depending on which way you wanted to read this. And that means my arrow needs to go in that direction. So those are just two examples on how to graph inequalities.